This is my best friend, Garth Elgar.
Hi.
I think we'll go with a little Bohemian Rhapsody, gentlemen.
Good call.
I see a little silhouette of a man.
Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the fandango? Thunderbolt and lightning, very, very frightening me.
Galileo,
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 Galileo, Figaro.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another edition of Matchbox Mark's Diecast Restorations. So, I'm continuing on another theme build. And, of course, from my intro, you already know what it is. But if I didn't put that intro in there, could you guess the movie car? Well, it is Garth's car in Wayne's World. So, if you're not familiar with Wayne's World became a movie from the skit on Saturday Night Live starring Mike Myers and Dana Carvey. Dana Carvey plays Garth, and this is his car, the AMC Pacer. So let's take a look at it. It is, here we go, the Corgi Jr.'s AMC Pacer. And we've got four posts. And a little bit of overkill, but nonetheless, we'll get her done. So, this skit from Saturday Night Live kind of catapulted Mike Myers to stardom. He eventually went on to play the voice of Shrek and Austin Powers in several other movies. He's really funny. And I grew up on Saturday Night Live when it was the Not Ready for Primetime players with Dan Aykroyd, John Belushi, Jane Curtin, Gilda Radner, Garrett Morris, and all them funny actors. It was really, really good. Still on the air today. So anyway, thanks to Lorne Michaels, awesome creator. So, all right. So I'm going to take this AMC Pacer. And I'm going to convert it into the Garthmobile, so stay tuned. All right. Let's bring a little Pacer to the maintenance floor and see what we've got. So obviously, not a fan of the interior. That'll be painted. I'll be detailing a lot of the exterior stuff to match the movie. And while I'm taking it apart, a little history of the movie. Came out February 14th, 1992. Valentine's Day. And a couple years later, they did come out with a sequel. And the premise of the show is they've got two guys in the basement of a house broadcasting on a public access TV channel. And the original Pacer was in 1976. And it sold at auction for $37,500. So, there you go. Alright, let's take it apart. Four posts. Kind of difficult taking them apart, drilling them out. Just had to do it slowly. Let's take it out. I'm not going to tap out the holes on this one. I'm just going to do just super gluing baking soda because there's no reason to tap four holes. This base is as light as a feather. So I'm going to do something with the wheels because in the movie, one of the hubcaps is not matching. So I need to figure that out. And here's the Pacer. All right, here's the body. I'll smooth down those posts. And the beautiful chrome interior, which is going to go. And the glass, which obviously I'm not going to do nothing with. Going to keep it original. So, there we have it. Wayne's World, the Garthmobile. Or not yet, but it will be. All right. Stay tuned. Take this baby to the stripper. My camera will shut off. Alright, I guess I'll have to do it manually. I have a Bluetooth and sometimes it doesn't like to connect, so. Alright, stay tuned. Alright, so here's a little pacer. Got her all cleaned up. I'm going to put a coat of primer on it. Stay tuned. Alright, it is time to assemble the Wayne's World car. So we'll start with the interior. In the movie, the seats were black with the tan centers. And detailed the front end. Like that. And the grill is kind of like a black silver. I combine black paint with the chrome paint pen. Can barely tell the difference. And here's the back. Got the number plate, reverse lights. And then, I'm going to put it together and do the final reveal. Stay tuned. All right, before we take a look at the finished product, let's see what I started with. Just a run-of-the-mill AMC Pacer put up by Corgi. And, all right, let's see what I ended up with. All right, it is time for the reveal for the Mirthmobile, as it's called in the movie. So here we are, the AMC Pacer done up in Wayne's World style. This is actually pretty fun. We'll start off with the paint. I actually matched, I tried to match it. I went with the light blue and I added some white to it to kind of brighten it up. And I got the flames and the number plate from eBay. Did the chrome handle there. And then as it's coming around, did the front end, turn signals, bumper. Did the black on the bumper. And the only thing that I couldn't do was both front hubcaps were different than the back. So that's the only thing I couldn't quite pull off. So anyway, there we go. Well, I hope you like it. It was fun doing it. Leave a comment, like, subscribe, and all that good jazz. Got a lot of cool builds coming down the pipeline. So stay tuned, stay safe, and I'll catch you on the next one.
That's all, folks.